I am Anders Hagstrom with the Daily Caller, and with me today is Catalina Lauf. She's running for Congress in Illinois, the 14th District, against Lauren Underwood, an incumbent Democrat who was elected just in 2018 recently. And don't forget to follow and subscribe before we get into this interview. So, Catalina, you would be the youngest person ever elected into Congress, which is previously a position held by AOC, who was elected when she was about 29. Obviously, most people don't tend to run for office at 26 years old. What made you want to?
So I was born and raised right here in this district of Illinois 14. My mom came here legally from Guatemala. My dad is a small business owner, and they were able to give me the American dream. I'm the direct product of the American dream. And I see that dream under attack today by these young, far-left, radical progressive women like AOC. And it's time that our party fights for freedom and brings in new voices that can combat the far left and the future that they want to bring to our country.
Mm-hmm. And obviously, as the daughter of a Guatemalan immigrant, you can speak to the immigration crisis in a way that a lot of Republicans are can't, or at least are afraid to often. You worked under the Trump administration for a while, and obviously the Trump administration has been highly criticized by the left for cruel immigration practices, in their words. Do you agree with them, or do you have a different opinion on that?
President Trump has done incredible when it comes down to messaging. What we need to focus on is that there is a huge crisis happening at the border, and he's the first person to really shed light on that and how grave if we don't combat what's happening down there. Our safety as Americans and as the country, not only for security, but also from the economy, is at risk. And so as somebody who is the daughter of somebody who came here legally, I've seen firsthand how hard it is to come to this country, but you need to do it in a right way. My family did it the correct way. They learned English. They immersed themselves into our country, and we're all Americans. And we need to focus that having a safe and secure border is not racist. It is the right for our country. But we need to also focus on merit-based type of immigration, exactly what President Trump has shed light upon. We need to focus on people who want to come here the right way and process people who want to be productive and add to our economy.
Mm-hmm. Would you say that is your signature issue going in once you're elected? Or what is the one thing that you would want to achieve once you are elected?
Immigration reform is a huge topic, not only because I've had firsthand experience, but it's also a huge topic in Illinois 14 and in Illinois as a state and in districts across the country. So I hope to contribute to the right side of the conversation and in ensuring that we do have a safe and secure border and that we are processing people here legally and encouraging legal immigration, cutting out loopholes and things like that. So it is a central part of my platform, and it's something that needs to stop being politicized by both people, by both sides of the aisle.
Mm-hmm. And what do you think is the reason? Because conservatives for a long time have been lambasted for not being able to reach a young millennial audience like the two of us, I suppose. But mm-hmm. Bernie Sanders, I think, has proven, or at least the traditional excuse has been that Republicans can't appeal to those voters because they're largely old white men. But obviously, Bernie Sanders has proved that's not true because a large segment of his base is extremely young, and yet he is the oldest candidate, I believe, running for office or running for president right now. So what sort of ideas do you bring to the table that can help Republicans get that vote, help them appeal to young people in the same way that Bernie Sanders has?
Absolutely. So let's not forget that Bernie Sanders has an incredible mouthpiece of his, AOC, who does dominate the millennial platform now. She has, you know, 6 million followers. I'd love to see the statistics of how many of those are millennials. I would say a large portion of that, because she's able to message in a peer-to-peer way that millennials just haven't seen. There aren't a lot of young people in Congress. So my hope is to, you know, broaden our base. There are a lot of millennials that would be considered conservative, but they just haven't been brought on our side. But there's also a big cohort of millennials that are just so apathetic to politics. But what we need to understand is that our country is at risk when we have far radical socialists like AOC bringing in millennials. Well, what are we doing on this side to bridge that gap with the people who are fierce conservatives on the millennial side, but also bring in new people from the millennial cohort? I hope to do that. I hope to be a voice, just like Congressman Dan Crenshaw, Elise Stefanik. They are both incredible millennials, but we need more. They cannot do it alone. Somebody like myself, I am Hispanic, and we also need to grow our minority base. And it's not to play identity politics. It's just that our districts change, our demographics change. And if we don't bring in new people to our party is lost.
Mm-hmm. And what would you say is the greatest danger facing America as a country, both foreign and domestic, right now? Because obviously there's been some fear about a conflict with Iran. Then there's healthcare issues, which is massive in the United States right now. Immigration. What would you say is the greatest issue facing America right now?
I would honestly say our divide. What's happening internally, especially when you have these loud voices on the far left that try to divide us by race and gender and ethnicity, that's more detrimental than any policy that's happening, because united we stand, divided we fall. And we need to get to back to a place that we are being all Americans, putting America first. President Trump has done an incredible job with his America First agenda, but we need to ensure that we are strong within, and that helps with, that comes with replacing this Democrat-controlled Congress that all they do is divide, and putting people who want to get everybody together and focus on being all Americans.
Mm-hmm. So President Trump has been, he's widely popular among conservatives. He has something like a 90% approval rating among Republican voters. So obviously Republicans like what he's doing, but do you think he's been a force for unity more generally?
I have. I think the Republican Party especially is unified more than ever. I will also say that there are a lot of Democrats who support President Trump's message, especially with all of this happening with the impeachment and every scandal that they try to create has actually united Americans more than ever. He has the highest, very high now record people, minorities that are hopefully going to vote for him now in 2020. He's bringing in women. He's bringing in independents and moderates and some Democrats now that are just so embarrassed by what the Democrat Party has created and how they've caved to the far left. So I think he's actually been unifying the country under his America First message.